This brings us to the central question, the question of let's examine the central question. Let's examine the true facts in another way.
You don't want to live.
Sometimes you don't want to live. But you get over that.
Sometimes you don't want to live.
But you get over that.
What you don't get over is the idea you know most people have.
You had it once too. The idea you know most people have.
But you get over that.
You don't get over the idea you know most people have.
You don't want
the idea you know most people have.
You had it once too.
Get over that.
Anyone. Anyone at all.
You had it once too.
People have. But the truth is, it may be you. Sometimes you don't get over that.
Sometimes you don't live.
Capitalism's distribution of wealth and its great wealth production overshadow anything the communists and the socialists have to show.
I have tasted fire. I have tasted hate. Destruction is also great.
Get over that.
Desire destruction.
Anyone. Anyone at all.
Desire destruction. Fight son up of hate, not of hate. I hold to those of desire destruction. Son up of hate, not of the world. I have tasted of destruction. I desire destruction. The world will perish twice.
The profit motive and the competitive market are wholesome and good.
The idea you know most people have.
We must examine the distribution of the great wealth produced through the operation of American capitalism. Is the distribution widespread? Or is the wealth of America concentrated in the hands of a few, as the socialists and communists say? We know that American capitalism is morally right because its chief elements, private ownership, the profit motive, and the competitive market are wholesome and good. They are compatible with God's laws and the teachings of the Bible. The opportunity of every American for a still better living standard will certainly be enhanced.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.